from the crypt. Thanks, pal. For nothing. I tell you, kiddies, things are tough all over. What with my expenses going up, and suddenly finding out I owe the DIRS a fortune, your pal the Crypt Keeper's had to find himself a second job. Still, it's worse for the people in tonight's tattletale. It concerns a group of inmates at the local home who've got a few horrid choices of their own to make. I call it Revenge is the Nuts.
Goddamn bathroom again. Son of a bitch! I hear you, Grunwald. You no good scum sucking. Damn! You think you got me this time, do you?
Don't panic, Samuel. I'm coming.
And I'm going. Right in this goddamn office.
In your pants, Sammy boy.
In your eye! Shit for brains.
The 710 slip on the slider.
Oh, shit.
Yes! God, I love this game.
It ain't right, Arnie.
Mr. Grunwald Doofus, how many times do I have to tell you that to you, I am Mr. Grunwald?
There's a girl in my office.
She's in your sitting room. Mr. Grunwald, can I help Samuel now?
Keep it up, Four Eyes, and your dog meat. Now go find the girl.
Hello? Hello? I'm blind, not stupid.
The seat's just ahead of you on your right.
You can learn a lot from a woman's shoes. Screamers usually wear spiked heels. Tight asses pumps. I wonder how combat boots will fit in.
Oh, keep it in your pants.
I see. Angry, are we? Well, let me set you straight. Sheila, it is Sheila, isn't it? You're here under my care because the county put you here. So for at least the next 6 months, you can consider yourself one of my subjects.
Well, who the hell died made you king?
In the land of the blind, even the one-eyed man is king. If you know what's good for you, you'll do things my way. Benny! Take Cinderella here to the ballroom. What do you think, Mother? Prime piece of meat, yes? You jealous old bitch.
What a scumbag that guy is. Why don't you leave me the front door and just let me out of this place, all right?
No, ma'am, I can't. Mr. Grumwald would... he'd be very upset.
It's his problem anyway. His mother didn't take him around for Halloween.
No, ma'am. His mother was blind. Just like you.
Come on, be a sport. Let me go. I'll make it worth your while.
No. You don't... you don't understand.
You're Grumwald's boy. I understand fine.
No, you don't understand. You don't understand. If I cross him, he'll send me back.
Where?
State Hospital. Reedville.
It's a mental hospital, isn't it? What'd they lock you up for?
My brother. My brother had me committed.
Sorry about that, Chief. You've just been shafted.
Everybody, this is Sheila. Sheila, this is everybody. Now, your bed is just four beds down on the right. It's just the end of the room. There's a blanket and some extra clothes if you want them. Mr. Grunwald, he gets those clothes for free from the country club.
This place smells horrible.
It grows on you, literally.
Well, sorry, pal, I ain't staying. Hey! Is there a window in this place? Somebody answer me!
Yeah, we got windows, but they've all been boarded up. Mr. Grunwald thinks blind people don't need no light.
Well, I don't understand. I thought his mother was blind.
She was. And if she hadn't left this place to the state and cut him out of her will, none of us would have to have anything to do with that asshole.
What the hell is that?
Your train out of Atlanta.
Every hour on the hour.
Shit, I gotta get out of this place. I can't.
Now, calm down, honey. Calm down. No use fighting a choke chain.
Look, it might work for some people, but it does nothing for me.
You ain't getting out, sugar. Now, that's the point. I mean, you might get as far as the front door. Osgood made it there once. Matter of fact, that's Osgood's foot you got in your hand right now. At least, what's left of it after Grunwald's dog got hold of it.
Oh, God! Oh, God!
Bruno, shut up! If you're that hungry, dig up Mother in the garden.
Oh,
Here she is, Mr. Grunwald.
Benny. Say ah. Hole in one.
Look, you slimy bastard, I'm not like the others. I'm not gonna lie down while you take advantage of me.
Interesting turn of phrase. Render unto Caesar that which is Caesar's, and unto God that which is God's.
What?
The other day, didn't you offer Benny a little something if he'd let you go?
Son of a bitch.
Oh, don't blame Benny. It wasn't his fault. I was right behind him. I heard the whole thing. The problem is, you were talking to the wrong person.
So if I sleep with you, you'll let me go?
Well, it's not quite that easy. I'm really not that big on one-night stands. If you want to leave, we'll have to take it one day or night at a time.
Up yours.
Not really my style. Strip away this thin veneer of sophistication, and underneath, you'll find I'm just an upfront kind of guy. Benny! Take the blind bitch away.
It's okay. I'll take you back.
Thank you, Benny. I'd appreciate that.
I really think you should reconsider my offer. I can be very persuasive when I want to be.
And none of us deserves to be here. We haven't done a damn thing.
We all been through this. We all raged against it. But at the end of the night, here we are.
Oh, no, not for long. You know Benny's keychain? He's got a little pocket knife that hangs on it.
Yeah.
I borrowed it.
Oh.
Where's the nearest way out of here?
Through Grunwald's office. It's the only way. You sure about this?
Yes.
To introduce you to Bruno. He'll be handling security here from now on. It's only fair to warn you, he hasn't eaten for 2 days, and he's particularly fond of fresh meat. Isn't that so, Osgood? So, if there are no objections, I suggest you all return to your quarters. Sticker. I don't think Bruno will be particularly concerned.
Knife was for you, asshole.
Where the hell you been, boy? I was beginning to think we weren't gonna get fed at all today.
Sorry, everybody. Just one meal a day from now on.
Low life, son of a bitch.
There you go. I'm sorry, miss.
Then you want his lousy food anyway. Can't we at least get some heat in here?
Mr. Grunwald says... Grunwald says, Miss? He changed his offer. He's not gonna let you go if you sleep with him. But he said that he'd turn the heat up and bring the rations back to normal. I wish there was something I could do.
It's not your fault, Benny. You're a prisoner just like the rest of us. Well, now, how long could it possibly take?
Don't be ridiculous, girl. We can't let you do that.
Well, it's not like I've got to look at him.
We ain't that cold nor hungry. Not yet.
It's like you said, Samuel. No use fighting a choke chain.
No. 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 We're not going to let you do it. And that's the end of it.
I be a chain.
Osgood?
Let the girl go. What the hell? Let's do Grunwald's way for a change.
I thought this was how it would turn out. I'm only sorry it took so long.
What can I say? I'm a slow learner.
Why do I find that hard to believe? To blind love.
Shall I undress?
Why don't you leave that to me? What soft, what light through yonder window breaks.
You want to play rough?
We can play rough.
It's all right, miss. It's me, Benny. My brother's not gonna bother you anymore.
Thank you.
means shock treatment, Benny. Electricity! Clever, Benny.
I'm getting out of here. And when I do, I'm going to my office. And when I get there...
Sit. Good girl. Hello there, Arnie. We can't find the food anywhere. Bruno's awfully hungry.
Now listen to me, you little pissant. You haven't got the guts.
That's okay, because we do.
I'm your own flesh and blood, for God's sake.
So was Mama. But you killed her anyway.
It was an accident. She tripped on the goddamn marble.
I may be a little crazy, Arnie, but not stupid.
Well, what are you going to do when they call for Mr. Grunwald, huh? What are you going to do then?
Oh, I'm Mr. Grunwald.
In your eye, shit for brains.
Say good night, Grunwald.
Grunwald. One little problem and he goes right to pieces. At least now we know what's really eating him. As for me, kiddies, I think I've got my money problems licked. I don't know why I didn't think of this sooner. Talk about a killing. Everybody loves finger food. Hey, you want a side of ghoul slaw with that?